Good day to you all.
Good day, good day. Yes.
Top of the morning to you, laddie.
She snuck in on me and I started saying, well, Nancy's not here, we're not going to start yet. And she says, yes, she is right here. All right. So, yeah. It has been an interesting week in Cedar Rapids, let me tell you. Our book study that we started two Wednesdays ago, this past Wednesday, I didn't have power or internet, so it's a little hard to host a Zoom meeting. Hopefully, they're saying that the vast majority of power will be restored in Cedar Rapids no later than Tuesday. Mediacom is saying within 24 hours of restoring electricity, their services will be available. So, knock on wood, I'm hoping that this coming Wednesday's book study will happen. If not, we'll get the word out again, but hopefully that will happen. We do still have a couple of extra copies of Good Grief up here if you want to jump in with the group. At this point, you've only missed the opening session. So, let's see. What else announcement-wise? That's about the only thing I had for sure that I wanted to make sure got said today. Anything else going on in life of community or church or that we need to be aware of? So for our, I don't see anybody popping. Okay. So for our music today, I just decided I needed to have some fun with some music today. The opening song, you'll notice there's no orders of worship, also no access to printer, and so I know what's going on, in theory, at least I have it written down. So we're going to open with a children's version, VBS version of He's Got the Whole World in His Hands, because I think I need to be reminded of that today. Yeah. And when we get to the prayer song, the prayer of St. Francis, Prayer of Peace, by the lovely Maureen McGovern. And then our closing song today, I was reminded that when I was serving the church in San Luis Obispo, the community started hosting the California International Choir Festival. And the woman who did the promotion for that was a member of our church. So we got to have one of the choirs come and sing and worship. And it's the choir from Uganda. The stole I'm wearing today is fabric from Uganda that they sold. And I had a wonderful seamstress in our church that fashioned it into a stole for me. And I do not know the name of the song they sing. They're singing in Swahili, so unless one of you knows Swahili, we ain't going to have a clue as to what they're saying. But talk about a choir that knows how to put into music, you know, make a joyful noise unto the Lord. So that's going to be our closing song today. So let's be reminded about God having the whole world in His hands, no matter what else.
That's the phone in the office. Oh, I'm sorry. Or maybe they're talking about Trump. We get those a lot.
So we've Been praying about COVID-19 and the pandemic, which we still don't seem to be able to get a cap on. We've been praying about the racial unrest that continues to be a part of our current reality. And then on top of that, as I told our daughter when she came over this morning to stay with Linda, while I came out here, because she didn't feel comfortable in staying alone. She's still really dealing with anxiety and stuff. I said, you know, if somewhere where they don't do snow, if you want to know what to do when you get hit by a blizzard, Iowa will come and show you, because we know how to do it. We don't know how to do hurricanes. Because over in Cedar Rapids, Linda and I did not get the word early enough, and we wrote this one out at home. And I have been through earthquakes in Southern California, and that's what it felt like. And it lasted for 72 minutes. Average earthquake lasts for 30 seconds.
Dang.
Boy, howdy. We was rocking and rolling. It's a war zone in Cedar Rapids. I've never seen what I'm seeing. We are very fortunate. Very little structural damage, most of it cosmetic. But our homeowners insurance is recommending that before we go get new skirting and button everything up so it looks nice again around our mobile, that we have a complete undercarriage inspection, which seems very prudent to me. You know, let's check those gas lines. Let's check those electric lines. Let's make sure those pillars are still underneath the I-beams where they need to be before you put the skirting up and say, it's all good. We lost power noon Monday and we still don't have it back. So I'm praying for those crews. It's like, come on. I've seen other places in Cedar Rapids. It's getting hard to find ice. You know, come on, crews, let's get this going here. I've only heard of one loss of life, that there was a person riding a bike that got hit by a tree. Other than that, there has been a lot of property damage. There's a whole lot of corn laying down in Linn County.
There was two people in Tallahassee County that died.
Oh, okay.
One was an electrician that was electrocuted, who was working, and another one, lady who was on her
porch that day. Oh. So yeah, now I know why a friend who moved to Florida for a job lasted one season, came back and he said, I'll deal with snow and occasional tornado. I am not going to deal with hurricanes. I now understand why. So, for the people whose lives have been upset, and that includes the crews from all over the country that are here trying to help us get back to normal. So, for everybody whose lives were touched by this derecho, never heard that term before. Evidently, it's a Midwest hurricane. So, other persons, joys, concerns that we need to be aware of as we come to prayer today? It's never this quiet, isn't it?
There was one family in particular yesterday that I talked to. We were down on our drive growing over 2,000 pieces of meat. That when you put out a call, we get a call on Friday night from Jen Gordon, Mitch Dolan's friend that's been here at Lord's Aid today, that she goes, sure, you've got to come help. She goes, we're growing on a little grill. And it was the smallest grill I've seen in a long time. So six of us went down and I put out three calls, and we got over $800 of donations from Pay It Forward, Delaware County, and from Amherst County, the Butte County Supervisor. She goes, I want to do something, but I don't know what to do. So I called her back and said, you in? What do you mean? I said, I need cash. And she goes, I'm in. So she's sending money to cover the product we took, and we're going to go again with our local pork producers and do co-op. Legion sent me down, and she said, will you grow whatever we got? I said, we'll grow whatever you got. But one family was a young couple with two little kids that have three deaths in the immediate family in 2 years, and he is having renal failure. The little kids were like 4 and 2. And Brandon and can't remember her names, the little kids' names were Owen and Patty. But they just, they said, "Be prayed, you know, would you do prayers for us?" Just, they are just really struggling. They have so many other people down there, but they in particular asked for prayers.
So is Brandon the one with the renal failure?
Yes.
Yeah, again, silver linings. I don't know if you heard, but somebody stole the generator from the Cedar Rapids Humane Society. Now, you can get a fairly heavy-duty generator for about $1,000. So the bad news is somebody stole the generator. The good news is people stepped up and they ended up getting $20,000 in donations. So they're going to get a new generator and about 19 grand on top. So, you know, you just want to find the perpetrator that took the generator and go, nah, 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 nah. Anybody else? And let's be in prayer again. Creator God, creating still. It's always good when we can gather with our family and faith to bring you praise, to be reminded of what it means to dare to call ourselves Christian, and to pray. To pray for ourselves and to pray for others. It's not very hard these days to find places where things aren't going the way I'm convinced you would have them go. And there would be those that say, oh, this is God's way of testing us. There are even those that would say, this is God's punishment to us for straying from God's ways. But that doesn't fit the image of you that Jesus brought to us. Yes, that is how the ancient Hebrews understood you, a God of war, a God of vengeance, a God of do good or God going to get you. And Jesus said, oh, no, 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 no. My God, my Father, is a God of love and compassion and acceptance and tolerance. But you have the gift of free will. And that means sometimes things are going to go differently than you might prefer. And when those things don't go well, that's when we get to show God what we're made of. How do we respond compassionately in so many ways? We can pray for a young man with renal failure, other deaths in the family. That's tough. We give thanks for those who respond with, people need to eat. Let's grill some food. And as I've said virtually every Sunday as I've stood in this pulpit, when we're not sure what else to do because we just feel like there's so much going on, we can always pray. We can pray for all those we know and those we don't know that are struggling in body and mind and spirit, asking that, not that your presence be near them, because we know that's the case, but that they be open to feeling your presence and strength and encouragement to help them get through the tough times. Lord, you tell us that with you, indeed, all things are possible, and we believe that. There have been times in recent days when we may have doubted that. Doubting is a part of life and faith. So be with us during these times. Help us to do what we can, large or small, And help us to know, even when we absolutely feel we are alone, that you are with us. And for that, we are eternally grateful. And now, in a moment of quiet, we would each bring before you those special prayer concerns that we feel most deeply in our own hearts and minds this day.